Hi, hello, how are you everyone? This is Hamidul Islam, you are most welcome to Let's Learn Science. Today in this session we will talk about one of the most important topic of 9th class biology from the lesson The Fundamental Unit of Life. So our today's topic is nucleus. Today we will talk in this session about nucleus. We will try our level best to learn about this nucleus. As you come to know that the structural organization of the cell, they have a cell membrane, then they have a nucleus and they have a cytoplasm. And along with that, if it is a plant cell, they also possess what? A cell wall. So far we have learned about plasma membrane and cell wall. So let us see today about this commonness of the cell. That means each and every kind of cell is used to contain what you know, nucleus. First of all, let us see what is the shape of nucleus. The shape of nucleus is spherical, or you can say that one, or you can say oval. What is the shape of the nucleus? It is spherical shape or oval shape. It is spherical or oval shape. Then, you know, nucleus is double membrane. It has, what is it? It has double membrane. Double means two membrane. It has two membrane, double membrane. Or you can say it is double layer membrane. That means nucleus possesses two membrane. One is outer membrane, another is inner membrane. So that's why it is called what you know? Nucleus is double layer membrane. Double layer membrane. Then you see inside the nucleus. What is found? Inside a nucleus, who is to get? Inside a nucleus, what is found? Chromosome is used to form. Inside a nucleus, what is there? Chromosomes is there. Are you getting the point? I am giving you in a sequence way. What are the things that are required to know? Up to 9 standard about nucleus. In that sequence manner, I am giving you. Try to get my point. So they have a chromosome, and chromosome is composed of what? By what chromosome is made up of? It is made up of DNA and what you know, protein. Chromosome is made up of DNA and protein. Now what is DNA? DNA, as you know, it is the full form of DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. Deoxyribonucleic acid, and that contain the information which is to, you know, take the inheritance characteristic from, you know, one generation to another generation. Yes. So this important thing contained in which chromosome, and what does chromosome is for? Chromosomes is found in the nucleus. Right. And you know, the functional segment of DNA is called gene. What I told you? The functional, the segment of the DNA which can carry out function, right? That is functional segment of DNA, a segment, a part of DNA that can carry out function is called what? You know, the functional unit of DNA is called gene. What is called? Genes. Right. And genes are responsible to carry the genetic information from or genetic character from one generation to another generation. Or this, you know, genes is responsible to carry the or to transmit the, you know, the different characteristic from parents to new offspring. And like this way, whatever the characteristic, the genetic characteristic is to transfer generation after generation. Right. Next you see, DNA, you know, DNA in a cell is present in the form of chromatin material. In the form of what? Chromatin material. Chromatin material. And when a cell is used to divide, then the chromatin material is used to organize in the cell. And like this way, when the cell is still divided, that new cell also possess what is known DNA. And that is responsible to carry the genetic information from one generation to another generation. Right. Now let us see one thing. Is it clear? So what is it done? What is the shape of the nucleus? The shape of the nucleus is spherical or oval. Right. Then what you come to know? Nucleus is composed of what you know? Chromosome. Chromosome is made up of what? DNA and what you know? Protein. And then what is the function of DNA? That full form of DNA? Deoxyribonucleic acid. Then what is gene? Gene is the functional segment of DNA. It is a segment of DNA that can carry out function. That segment of DNA is called what you know? That is called genes. Now you see, I have told you know that nucleus is called control center of the cell. It is called the control center of the cell. Or you can call it is the headquarter of the cell. Right? Or what can you call? You can call it the headquarter of the cell. Why it is called control center of the cell? Because it is to give direction for all the activities of the cell. That means what are the different types of activities have to be performed in the cell, that direction is given by what you know, the nucleus. That's why it is called control center of the cell. Or it is also called the headquarter of the cell. It is similar to that of our brain. Because we used to carry out each and every function, no? So, that to perform different kind of function, that direction is given by what? The brain. Then, our brain is the master organ of our body. In the same way, nucleus is the control center of the cell because it is to give direction for each and every activity of the cell. Is it clear? Besides that also, it is to perform some other function also. It is to perform what you know? Some other function also. It helps in the cellular reproduction of the cell. Cellular reproduction. It helps in the cellular reproduction. Cellular reproduction means what? When a cell is to divide to form a new cell from the pre-existing cell. So in that case also, what will help to divide the cell? The nucleus will help to divide the cell. And the multiply of cell, the multiply of cell from the pre-existing cell, or the reproduction of the cell, that is one cell divide to form the new cell, that is called what you know? Cellular reproduction. What it is called? Cellular reproduction. What it is called? Cellular reproduction. Besides that also, it used to direct that after the formation of the new cell, that cell have to be perform what kind of activity in the body. That are also determined by or that one also directed by what you know? Nucleus. That are also directed by what? Nucleus. That's why it is called the what you know? Called a control center of the cell, or you can also call that one as a, you know, the headquarter of the cell. Now, another thing is that it's very important to know that we have got about, what do you know, let's call, sorry one minute, we have called about that there are two types of cell. We have got about prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. What cell? Prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. We have got about prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cell and what you know? Eukaryotic cell. prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Right? Or simply it is called prokaryotics and this one is eukaryotic. Eukaryotes, procreates or eukaryotes. Or you can say prokaryotic cell, the organism which has prokaryotic cell, therefore procreates, and the organism that has eukaryotic cell, that are called eukaryotes. Okay. Now these two types of cell has been divided into these two categories, that is prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell, that is also based on the types of nucleus that is found in a cell. In the prokaryotic cell, what happened, the nucleus that is present, that is without the nuclear membrane. That means in the prokaryotic cell, there is lack of nuclear membrane. As we got know, nuclear is what? It is double membrane. There are two type of membrane. One is outer membrane and another is inner membrane. So in the prokaryotic cell, what happened? There is lack of nuclear membrane. That means in the prokaryotic cell, nucleus is there, but that nucleus lack of what nuclear membrane. Or you can say, as it is lack of what nuclear membrane, so that is not distinct. That is at the primitive stage. That is at the primary stage. Or you can say prokaryotic cell lack of oil-defined. It doesn't have the oil-defined what nucleus. And that type of cells are called what prokaryotic cell. Right. Then what is called eukaryotic cell. In the eukaryotic cell, what happened? Nucleus is present. Over here nucleus is also present. Here also nucleus present. But along with what? Nuclear membrane. That means in the eukaryotic cell, nucleus present along with the what? Nuclear membrane. But in the prokaryotic cell, nucleus is present, lack of nuclear membrane. That means the nucleus doesn't possess the nuclear membrane in case of prokaryotic cell. Right. Now I will say that, sir, you are saying that nuclear membrane, what is the function of the nuclear membrane? Right, it's also very important to know. Question may arise about the function of, or is it the function of nuclear membrane. Now let's see. Nuclear membrane. There are two nuclear membrane. That means nuclear is, nuclear has a double layered of membrane. And the membrane that is, encloses the content of the nucleus, that is called nuclear membrane. And the nuclear membrane is somewhat, porous. It has some pores. With the help of these pores present on the nuclear membrane, the nucleus is used to access the material between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Did you get it? That's all. What is the function of the nuclear membrane? Then with the help of the nuclear membrane, the nucleus is used to access the material. What does it do? It is to access the material between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Right? That means it allows something to enter inside the nucleus with the help of nuclear membrane. And it used to allow some material or substances to go or to exit from the nucleus to the cytoplasm. So this is the means. This is the means, that is nuclear membrane. It helps in the exchange of material between the nucleus and the cytoplasm, or can say in the nucleus and out of the nucleus. Right? That is with respect of what? Cytoplasm. So this is the function of nuclear membrane. So this is all about today's session. If you have any doubt, any confusion, then please comment me in my comment section. And if you like my video, then please subscribe the channel and share it. Thank you.